Yeah. Oh. That's a vibe. She wanna vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah.
What is going on, everybody? It is March the 3rd. Happy Sunday if you guys are listening to us randomly on Sunday, even though we record this on Sunday, so nobody is listening to us on Sunday. Excited to have you guys here. Welcome to the Vibe Check. Excited to have you guys with us for another week. Episode 3, gents. We've already done two episodes. Episode 3 of the Vibe Check. If you're watching the visual version, you just saw a lot of balloons from Shaggy Betts, which we're excited to have you guys here. Do them all. Exactly. Exactly. This is brought to you by Betting News, and this is your weekly podcast talking a little bit about sports, a little bit about entertainment, and everything in between. Excited to have you guys here. My name is Sweatpants Jesus. We got Colby Marcio in the house. We got Shaggy Betts. We got NZ, and we got Mr. Jess Sook, or Sook, or Jess Sook, or however you want to do it. I don't know. He got it up there. He got it up there. If you guys are watching the audio, the visual.
We got to bless our visual viewers. You know we love you.
Absolutely.
People.
Absolutely. If you're watching the visual version of this, which you should check out on YouTube if you're not already. If you're watching the visual version, our dog NZ put up a oh shit, I did the backwards version. Put up the hand sign.
You want to know something, SDJ?
He said Wu-Tang.
That's my fear every time that I'm gonna do it backwards.
Oh my god,
I do it down here. I do it down here like four times.
I'm like, which way? Left? Right?
It looks like NZ's beating himself up under the table.
Oh my god. That's so good, dude.
Off to a great
We had Betspresso yesterday, and NZ graced us with the Z, and now it is, now you must do it every single time. It's like the, and I'm Shaggy Betts. It's got you know, that.
Exactly. It's a staple now.
Exactly.
You did it to yourself.
Exactly. Exactly. For sure. Well, whether you guys are listening to this, what?
He said you did it to yourself. I said, I'm not upset about it.
No. Not at all.
That's right.
I'm glad you feel that way.
If you guys are listening to us in the middle of the week, we hope you're having just the fucking best week ever so far. If you're having a bad week, we hope that this podcast is going to make it better for you guys, because we are going to talk about what has happened last week. We're going to talk about some things we're looking forward to this week. And this week, we're going to play Two Truths and a Lie. We are going to play it with all of us. You guys in the chat, if you're watching this on YouTube, drop in the comments who you think's telling the truth and who you think's fucking lying on whichever ones we talk about on the show. It should be a little bit of fun for a little bit of... a little bit of action for you guys. But we are going to talk about some stuff that happened in the past week in the sports world, the entertainment world, or everything in between, and some things that we're looking forward to this week moving forward. Excited to have you guys with us. Thanks for stopping in. Shaggy's got his snacks hat on, which is probably my favorite hat that you own. Hat game strong, absolutely. But this might be my favorite that you have.
You got to have a strong hat game with the long hair. That's just an absolute fact. A lot of days, just slap on the hat, you're good to go.
You know what's you know what the shitty thing about having long hair is? That a lot of people don't realize. Because we both have. Have you guys had long hair in your life? Longer than that, Colby.
Colby's, but not. Colby's
pretty slowly.
And I know Shaggy probably can attest to this as well. But when you've had long hair, and I mean, my hair, if you guys are watching, is down to my shoulders. It used to be down to like the middle of my back. And Shaggy's is longer, a little bit longer than mine now. It's a fucking pain in the ass to maintain, man. If you don't like take care of your hair every 2 or 3 days, just it's done. You're not fucking. I spend 30 minutes in the shower just fucking brushing that shit out and cobwebs. Who the fuck knows? When we were living in the bus, dude, I would go like 7 days without, you know, being able to wash my hair because we'd be in different locations and stuff. It was also a pain in the ass. I literally looked homeless, straight up homeless. I mean, in a way, I kind of was, but like I had dreadlock, basically. It was terrible.
It's getting all matted back there.
Shit.
Yeah. How often do you wash your hair?
I mean, like, yeah, every few days, like you said.
Okay. Well, then you're not really dealing with it as much as I did. I got really lazy when I had short hair, though, dude.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. When I have short hair,
Never. You can't do that with long hair, though. You know, you can't. You win. All right. Enough things about the hair. Colby's like, what the fuck are we talking about, long-haired motherfuckers?
Yeah, I'm doing my
hair. We had a great two-minute start and then just fell off.
Yeah. Well, we had the Z threw us into a whole new loop as well.
Let's not forget that happened.
That will never be forgotten. Yeah, so to start us off this week, we're going to talk about all of us brought something that happened last week that we're looking that we enjoyed, that brought us joy, that we like, that we want to talk about. It doesn't have to be something awesome necessarily. And Shaggy, I will let you go first. What was something that happened last week that that stood out to you that that was either good, bad, or made you feel some type of way?
Yeah, it made me feel some type of way. It wasn't very awesome. KU got beat twice. That was awesome. You guys know me. I'm just going to keep bringing up sports. Lost at Allen Fieldhouse to BYU. Lost in Waco to Baylor. But Kevin McCullough was back on the court. So that's a plus. He's back. We get to smack little brother on Tuesday. Sunflower Showdown in Allen Fieldhouse on Tuesday. So that was fantastic. I also, while I am mentioning the Kansas State Wildcats, this did happen this week. I caused some trouble in Bramlage Coliseum. Let's put it that way. They don't appreciate it when you yell during Wildcats free throws, especially when it is a 43% free throw shooter at the line. We got out of there alive. Me and Chandler lived to tell the tale, and I will be doing that again if I get the opportunity.
You guys can go follow us on TikTok at Your Betting News, and you can actually get the whole story of what Shaggy did at Kansas State.
I'm sorry, David Gaston. It wasn't.
It was funny that you sent us that voice note, and it was awesome, and it was like, this must be a video, and then you proceeded to make it a video because you're great.
I made one like as I was walking out, and then I can't remember what happened to it. By the time I got to the car, it didn't upload or something, but it is what it is.
One of my least favorite things is when you spend a lot of time making an incredible TikTok and then for some reason it doesn't save or it doesn't load.
The app's got so many bugs, man. So many bugs.
It's a pain.
I hate it.
I've never been a TikTok, so I can't relate.
Boo!
All right. I can't remember what was the thing that you said that needed to happen for you to make a TikTok? Did it already happen or has it not happened yet?
Yeah, I think it happened.
Oh, man. I fucking
I think I know what it was. I think it was getting 1,000 followers.
Ooh. It was!
Ooh. It was! Oh. Look at that dad memory. He's like, I heard you, youngin. You said that
I know
shit.
It's back there somewhere.
It was.
Follow through, son. Follow through.
Better be careful, Colby. I'm on to you.
I'll make a TikTok.
The TikTok is coming from Just Suck. I can't wait for this now.
Whip
it up. Okay, Mr. Marcio, what are you looking forward to this week? Or sorry, what happened last week that I moved to the end of the show. I thought we were at the end of the show already. What happened last week that got your palms tingling?
I'll count it as last week. It happened today. Caitlin Clark being the all-time leading scorer in college hoops history. Oh, get her back in the kitchen. She's in her fifth year. No one cares about women's sports. Suck a fat one, losers. Suck a fat one. The biggest college basketball player in the country is a woman. Oh, go make her a sandwich, losers. Boom. Some guy called me a moron because of that tweet I put out. He's like, she's not in her fifth year. Hey, dude, you don't even know what you are saying. And then I showed him what I was talking about. And he goes, oh, my bad. I'll take it back. Yeah, you're a real role model to your two kids in your bio, Mark.
Mark. Did you guys see that Travis Scott was there?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. Why? Because it's Caitlin Clark. Do you see who he dapped up in that video, though?
Jake from State Farm.
Yeah. Jake from State Farm, yeah.
He's everywhere, man.
I even felt bait to it. I saw the video of Travis Scott walk in, and the quote tweet was like, "You're never gonna guess who he daps up." I was like, "All right, I gotta watch the video and guess." Like, I gotta figure it out. Jake from State.
So, yes. My mom hates
Jake.
My mom hates Jake from State Farm. She thinks every time he
original or the new one.
Yeah, the new or the old.
The guy that is the Jake from State Farm now. Yeah. She every time he comes on a State Farm commercial and I'm doing something with my mom or watching a game or something, and she's like, "That guy, he's just got no talent and he got so lucky." And I'm like, "Mom, the guy's like, he's fine. Like, don't." She's like, "I just don't know. I don't like him." Yeah, I don't know. It's just such a weird thing that she hates Jake from State Farm.
Does she hate aggressive flow too?
I was gonna say,
that's the same logic, in my opinion.
It's also weird to see somebody who's only a commercial actor in like at like games, and he's being recognized as, "Oh, there's Jake from State Farm." Like, you don't see Flo, you don't see the caveman, you don't see the gecko. I've never once seen the gecko at a Knicks game. Have you guys ever seen the gecko at a Knicks game?
Riddle me. I saw a
black duck in traffic one time.
You did? Was he with Nick Saban?
So that would be amazing. So Flo actually. Flo actually was like a legit, and I hate to say legit actor, commercial actors are legit actors too, but like she was in television shows. She was like auditioning to be, you know, acting. And she got this break to be Flo. And obviously her life has now become where she's Flo and she makes a shit ton of money to be Flo. But as soon as you have that type of break in the commercial world, that's it. That's it. There's nothing else. It's like the, it's like the Allstate guy too. Like that guy. You know, the guy that Mayhem, you know?
Yeah.
Yep.
Same thing.
Even the AT&T
Sonic guy.
Wasn't he from movies previous, though? The Mayhem guy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Mayhem guy was.
Yeah.
He was, right? Okay.
He still acts in.
If you actually go and look up the actors that play Flo, Mayhem, AT&T girl, like Sook was just talking about, they have pretty substantial acting resumes before they became those characters. And they were just, you know, like they were in like TV shows or whatever.
AT&T girl was this close to being a Marvel superhero. She recorded a pilot, was a fan favorite character, and the show never got picked up. So I'm glad she's still making bank as the AT&T girl.
I hope absolutely. Sonic guys.
Sonic guys. But to get back to what you were originally talking about, what Caitlin Clark did was amazing. It was unbelievable. And I'll actually transition to what I was going to talk about, because I saw that LeBron James actually retweeted this and said, like, "Wow, it's amazing. She's done such an incredible thing." Right at the night after he became the first NBA player in NBA history to have 40,000 points to break that record. First of all, isn't it so cool, guys, that we're in a portion of sports right now where we're watching things that have never been done before. And we're getting to see it, I almost want to say weekly. I feel like every couple weeks, every month almost, we're seeing a record-breaking moment. You know, this thing happened. Like the guy at the combine that ran the fastest combine time ever from Texas. Oh, for sure. 100%. Fucking Joe Milton threw the ball 75 yards. He's going to fucking suck in the NFL. But he threw it 75 yards. Good for you.
I was just going to say one last thing on Caitlin Clark. I did see that, I think it was when she was in 7th or 8th grade, her dad could not find a girls' AAU team for her to play for. I think someone posted that today.
Because she was on a boys' team.
Yeah. That's
this insane. Really cool place called Betting News might have retweeted it that you checked out. That's cool.
Yeah. W plug.
Yeah. No, her dad had to have her play on a boys' AAU team. And apparently there were people in the crowd that were bitching about that she was a girl that played with boys. And she she was just fucking dicking on them. And they were pissed because they were sad. I actually played with girls when I played with... Let me keep going.
Go check out our
show. You're the one that stopped. You were the one that stopped.
You know when things leave your mouth?
Grade and I lost to a girl.
Nice. There you go. I played travel soccer when I was growing up, and we had two girls on our team. And so I played, and I mean, one of the girls was nobody fucked with that girl. She was one of our best players. She was awesome.
Be honest, that's usually what happens. Is I had a girl on my little league team, and it was because she was so good that they didn't even want her playing softball anymore because she was just destroying. And she came to play with the boys, and she was fucking like one of the best players in the league, probably like top three.
Yeah, that's Caitlin Clark times 20. times 30, yeah. Whatever.
100 million. Yeah. Trillion.
Yeah. 100%. That's a good one, Colby. But anyway, yeah. So what I was going to say was LeBron just scored 40,000 points the day after or the day before Caitlin Clark did what she did. So we saw back to back breaking records in the NBA and then the NCAA as well. But see, the thing for me about LeBron getting 40,000 points, which is amazing, first player in NBA history to ever do it. He also has 11,146 rebounds. He has 10,847 assists. He also has 2,255 steals, and he has 1,106 blocks in his career. Now, for me, and I know that this is, it will be a probably ad nauseum conversation topic that we're not going to have here, but he's the best player in history of the NBA, bar none for me. I think that he has become the greatest player of all time. As soon as he does officially retire, whenever that happens, I think that he will go down as the greatest overall player ever. I understand the conversation that Michael Jordan has more titles than he does. But if you want to judge it off of titles, Bill Russell should be the greatest player of all time. Bill Russell has 11 NBA championships. Sam Jones has 10. Do you guys know who Sam Jones is? Because I fucking don't. And fellow Celtic, indeed. Robert Horry has 7. That's more than Michael Jordan.
Sleeper.
With three teams. Teams.
People always forget about that.
Yeah.
Who was the third team?
I'm just saying.
Lakers and who? Who was the third team?
The Rockets, 1994
and 95. Oh, wow.
It's just unbelievable what LeBron's doing at his age. Everybody can have their own opinion on I don't really think that it matters who the greatest player of all time is. It's a bunch of bullshit. But for me, I've watched him since he came into the league. He epitomizes greatness in the way he carries himself, the way he plays basketball, the way he does everything on and off the court. And he's just fucking amazing to watch, especially at 39 years old. So it was an unbelievable moment to kind of witness, to see him score, overtake Kareem, and now become the first person in NBA history to score 40,000 points. Long live the king, man. Yeah.
Is this what the kids call glazing?
Yes.
Yeah. When he said this is going to be a long conversation, I was like, there's three dudes right here that don't even want to start the conversation.
No, I don't want to. It won't continue any further. The conversation is over now. But that, yeah. Yeah. It was a huge thing. He had 40,000 points.
Do you think anybody else ever gets 40,000 again, SPJ?
No. We talked about it earlier on Sauce Team, and these guys don't want to talk about the NBA, so we can skip this quickly. No.
So, Sook, I know the best thing that you saw this past week were the highlights of the Canada team going into third place, but I'll let you repeat it.
All right. Actually, the highlight of my week was Dune Part 2 came out on Thursday. Ooh, I was waiting for it all the whole time. It got delayed because of the strikes, and I was super pleased with how it turned out. It was a ride. I loved it. Can't wait for Dune Messiah to come out maybe in 3-4 years here. But directed by fellow Canadian Denis Villeneuve. I love all his movies. Prisoners, Sicario, guy's awesome. Every time he's probably the best director living right now, young, that's still making a lot of movies all the time. I know Scorsese and stuff, like, he was big back then, but how many people watched Killers of a Flower Moon, right? So I think Denis, like, the best working director right now, and Dune Part 2 was great. That was the best part of my week.
Well, I'm going to have to say this right off the bat. That was Mandarin to me.
The movie?
Yeah. You've never seen Dune?
You don't even... Was
I just know Zendaya is in it, and Timothy Chalamet.
Ruta calls Timothy Chalamet Timothy Shyamalama Ding Dong.
Nice.
Hopefully so.
Yeah, she also loves
it. Not Shamlet? Is that not how you say his name? It's not Shamlet.
Shyamalan. No.
Yeah.
Shyamalan.
Not Shamlet. Confirming.
Willy Wonka.
This week.
Yeah,
he was.
Yes.
He was.
Are we talking about the same guy?
It comes out this weekend.
Yes. I think Colby forgets sometimes that he's on camera.
Oh, I'm well aware. I got to get my my itch,
stretching.
My movement itches.
Tune into YouTube.
YouTube. Yeah, if You're watching the YouTube version. You just saw Kobe lean back. Real quick before we get in Z's favorite thing that happened this week. Did you see there was a, I can't remember if it was a tweet or something, Sook, about how a quote from the director from Dune saying that young people want long movies now. Like they want films to be, because Dune's almost 3 hours, right? Isn't it like two and almost two? It's like, I mean, I know that Oppenheimer was also really long. Some of the bigger blockbustery type movies have been 230, 240 runtime. What do you think about that? As someone who's written screenplays and things like that, like what's your thoughts on that?
I think what definitely happens in this like studio productions is that they rush these productions on so fast that the third act isn't really fleshed out, hasn't been rewritten multiple times. Screenwriters always say rewriting is writing. That's how you actually flesh something out into something proper and something that will hit the audience. So with all of these big budget tentpole movies, they fail in that third act. So then those movies feel like a slog. But when a director and a screenwriter and a whole production team have a vision, they can knock off these three and a half hour movies and you'll walk out of the theater surprised. Maybe you'll think it's Mandarin, but maybe you'll be surprised and you loved it and it went by real fast.
What's the longest thing you've ever written?
Like 140 pages. Actually, no. In university, probably my final paper.
How long was that?
Minutes of a,
I don't think it was like 20 pages or something. But it,
comedies in there?
20,000 words, I think, or some shit. No, I don't write comedies. I write historical.
Why is that?
I'm not very funny.
Disagree.
A bunch of horseshit.
I wanted you to say something like, because they're stupid, and be like, well, it's because it's the hardest thing to write.
You know, comedy is definitely the hardest thing to write.
I hate that you know, it's like no respect in the biz. It's literally impossible. You know how hard it is to just write a joke and like be like, this will be fucking awesome.
Dude, it's like Peter Farley. I don't know if you guys know who Peter Farley is, but he writes a lot of comedies. And he wrote Movie 43, one of the most panned movies of all time. But then a few years later, he wrote fucking Green Book and won the Oscar for Best Adapted Screenplay. Then there's Craig Mazin that wrote a bunch of bullshit comedies. And then he wrote fucking Chernobyl for HBO and won a bunch of awards for that. Now he works on, I think, Last of Us. You know, these comedy writers, even if those movies bomb, there's like kids in sixth grade that love that shit and their careers move on. And they're actually good writers.
Well, I was about to say, that's a good, like, it goes to show that, like, you can't pigeonhole yourself. Like,
no.
In anything that you do. Like, if you're a good writer, you're a good writer. Sometimes people have more of an area of an expertise, but, like, if you're a good writer, you're a good writer. Also, if you probably read a lot of comedy screenplays, they wouldn't be that funny. A lot of times the actors that do them end up making them funny with either impromptu shit that, like, a lot of the times, you guys ever watch like the bloopers or something or like the aftermath and they're like, yeah, that scene wasn't actually planned. It just happened, you know? Yeah. Like Robin Williams used to do like six takes of something before they actually found
Will Hunting, that last scene where he's like, the son of a bitch stole my line. That was like 30 takes in.
So Robin Williams was going to be nominated for an Academy Award for his performance as the genie in Aladdin, but he wasn't actually able to be nominated because too many of his lines were impromptu. Apparently they have like a limit on the amount of scripted lines you have to have in a movie to be nominated. And because he ended up in improvising a good portion of that role, they couldn't give him the nomination for it, which is insane.
Stupid.
It's crazy, right? Rest in peace, Robin Williams, man. Also, real quick, before we dive into NZ's favorite week, NZ's fucking dying to tell us right now. We just got news before the podcast started from NZ, actually, that Chris Mortensen died. Chris Mortensen from ESPN, very famous writer, journalist, and person that reported on sports for a long time for ESPN. If you guys are a follower of sports, you know who Chris Mortensen is. So rest in peace, Chris Mortensen. Don't know anyone close to you, anybody associated with you, but you were fantastic towards the sports world. You brought us a lot of incredible moments. So rest in peace to him and his family. So, all right, NZ, what happened last week for you, brother? That was something worth talking about.
I don't know. I just
it was his birthday.
I was gonna say I go more on the personal side that it was a good weekend celebrating the birth day of birth there, and I had another good work week on the corpse side, so I'll take that as a W as well.
Nice.
And yeah, you know, this past weekend we invented this. Everybody's loving this.
Can you explain to the people that are just listening what that is?
Yeah, they don't know what this is.
You got to talk it out like it's a game.
If you've seen the movie Dude, Where's My Car? And mm-hmm. all the bubble people worship the guy, the little man, Zoltan. So, and Z, you get it. Z, Zoltan, Z, yeah, Z. I almost said my last name like it was on the screen.
Zangy.
Yes.
Zanky.
There you go.
Court name.
Yeah, that's a solid one right there.
That is good. Yeah, that's good. That's better than anyone.
We'll take that as a W week recap. What are you gonna say?
I was gonna say, did you have a good birthday? Like, what was the highlight of your? What was the best moment of your birthday?
The golf swings.
Got to be the golf swings.
It's gonna sound so degen. It was when I was
hitting the lotto.
It was when I was driving home from fucking golf and we cashed the lotto.
Yeah. There you go.
Bang.
Let's go.
I was gonna say, I also had a pretty solid week in that betting thing that we're not talking about on this show, so that was cool too. That was a lot of fun.
When your wife listens to this, you're going to get the biggest punch in the nuts, dude. Well, congratulations on growing another year older, another year around the sun. We all love you. You get another one more NZ Glaze session for your birthday, and that's it. No more for another year. Who's the next birthday we have? We just... So Quinn's yours.
Me.
You might guess what? It's gonna be me. When's yours, Colby?
2 days after Shaq's.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So Sook is our next birthday.
Yeah, Chef's October. Trizzy just passed as well.
Man, I can't wait for May. I just can't wait for May. I can't wait for May.
My God.
Yeah, well, let's get a little explanation on the spoon.
We can't spill the footage.
Secretly, me and Kobe can't remember where it started.
I know where it started.
Do you remember exactly? I can't remember.
I'm not going to say what it is.
It's that bad.
It's pretty bad.
It's probably
I think you said it on a stream.
I said somebody said something dirty, and I said,
dirtiest thing I've ever heard, and it mentioned the spoon. You said, all right, fine. I'll say what it is. You said, I'll get the dirty seconds. I'll get the spoon out. And there was something like, it was along those lines. He's like, I'll take this. It was Baker Mayfield. He was like, you get all these seconds.
Oh, my God. It was about Baker Mayfield.
I'll be there in the background with a spoon.
You guys don't know, Colby and Sook are Baker Mayfield's two biggest fans.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. to get us back unhinged even more so than how hinged we are, let's play Two Truths and a Lie. We're in a good spot for it right now. Oh, man. Speaking of Sook's spoon. All right, Sook, get us started. Now, I'll explain to the people that are listening, if you guys have ever played Two Truths and a Lie, we highly encourage you to play with your friends next time you are sitting around hanging out with your amigos. The way it works is the three of us are going to give three pieces of information. Two of the pieces of information are true. And the third thing is a lie. And you guys have to, we have to figure out what's true and what's not. It's a good party game. It's good drinking game if you want to play it that way too. So chin to you. Lazy. Yeah, Kobe's lighting incense. He's getting ready for the moment. All right, Sook, take us away. Give us two truths and a lie.
All right, two truths and a lie.
I have had my knee experimentally reconstructed.
That's the
lie. I have two tattoos.
That's the lie.
And I've been with my wife for over 15 years, and I'm 31.
That's the truth.
That's the truth.
That's true.
That all we know is true.
So that's true.
You have more than two or less than two tattoos.
Shout out, Kanika.
Yeah, shout out, Kanika. Yeah, I'm going to go with the tattoo one as well, I think.
Let's see. Ooh, I got a good one for mine.
I got a good one.
You either have one or three or zero.
I think it's the – so you guys think that the lie is that he has two tattoos?
You said I have more than two.
Okay.
No, right, you said you had two?
Yeah.
You said more than two?
More than two.
Oh,
yeah. Are we talking, from betting terms, is this two plus or over two and a half?
Yeah, exactly.
Are we going over two and a half?
1.5 minus 120.
Dude, one time I, not to like get sidetracked, one time I got into an argument via email with one of the books because they were trying to tell me that four plus meant five. I was like, are you out of your cranium?
Oh, yeah.
No. And I'm like having to explain to them. I go, that is incorrect. That is not right. And they're like, yes, it is. And I go, I'll come through that. I'll come through my phone right now and beat the crap out of you.
That's not true.
You do not know what you're saying.
All right. Yeah, I think that you all. I'm going to go with the tattoos.
I'm going with the knee.
Going with the knee.
I'm going with the tattoos. Wild card. I'm going with
okay.
The wild card.
I'm on tattoos.
I have zero tattoos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've lost, Cole.
I know.
I did have my knee experimentally redone. Shout out, Dr. Razantsov.
He's been probed.
So, what did you have done on your knee then?
I always fuck up the explanation, and I'll fuck it up here again. Someone can correct me. I think sometime in the early 2000s, they discovered a new ligament in the knee, and they thought that
ligament.
Why,
yep.
That they thought that's why ACLs continue to fail after they're like fixed. Mm-hmm. So he takes a part of your hamstring and actually does another tendon. So then I went into the study blind, so I knew I was getting the surgery, but I didn't know which surgery I was getting till I woke up. And then even after, I had to like participate in the study and like do exercises for them and show them that I was going to get back to playing basketball regularly, because like the whole point of the sport was to get people 25 and under to return to their sports without re-injuring an ACL.
Did you tear your ACL?
Oh, yeah. I fucked my entire knee. Oh. Everything gone. Like, completely fucked.
Playing basketball?
Oh, yeah.
Well, geez, Marcus Lattimore.
Oh, and also, while I was getting back to playing basketball after I fucking fucked my knee up, I tore my Achilles clean.
Ooh,
oh.
On my other leg.
Damn. Wow, you're the goat.
It's always, yeah, right? It's always the other leg that, because it's overcompensating for the knee. That's shit, dude. Wow, okay. Fun times. All right. That was a good starting off. All right, from one spoon to another, Mr. Marcio, what's your two truths and a lie?
I have the same name tattooed on me twice. I have my girlfriend and I do not know the day we started dating. And
this is the truth. He's just trying to figure out what to say.
But this is the worst game ever. I'm trying to think.
It's a game you have to prep for.
Which is why I sent you guys the prep for it.
I thought I had three, and as soon as it was my turn, I blinked.
Have you heard of this thing called taking notes?
God damn it.
I'm going to go with the first one. I think the first one's the lie.
Hold on. Let me think of something. Hold on.
We'll edit this out. We'll fix this in post.
God
absolutely
damn
not.
It.
Nope. Definitely
no
not.
Redos. No more.
Would you like a minute? We could go to Shaggy if you'd like a minute.
What did I say? I said.
I don't know. They're your stuff.
I have two brothers.
Okay, so say them all again for the people listening in case we end up editing this out.
I have brothers. I have tattoos of a name of the same name twice, and my girlfriend and I do not know the day that we started dating.
Kobe has one brother.
I think he does two brothers, dude, for some reason.
Yeah, I think he does two. I'm gonna go.
I want to say.
I'm going with the name, the tattoos, even though that's
probably. I don't even think you have any tattoos. So I'm gonna go the tattoos as well. Oh, he does. How well do you guys know? What do you guys?
He took his shirt off the other day in a video.
Him and Kobe are the same person. You guys forget that. We figured that out when we fuck, married, killed Ken Pom Bartorovic in the House of Metric.
That's a fun game too.
I hear him again.
I have the same.
He doesn't even remember what they are.
I was too busy trying to figure out my own. Yeah, your girlfriend and you don't know when you started dating.
Yeah, and then that's so true. I have two brothers.
I'm gonna say the two brothers is the lie because the other thing sounds stunad, and you sound like you could accomplish both of those. The name twice, and then also not knowing your dating anniversary. So I'm gonna say you end up having sisters and not brothers.
All right, so are we ready for the lie?
Let's yes. Reveal.
I only have one brother.
There it is.
Was on me the whole time. When he said he's thinking of the lie, I was like, that's fucking idiot.
You know why? It's because I'm an attentive listener. When you guys were texting the other day, Kobe said my brother. People that have more than one brother, they tend to be like, I'm talking to one of my brother, my little brother.
One of my brothers.
He did not specify.
Disgustingly sickly nice. Thinking about what he says he that you nice remember
suck,
that.
Man. Oh, yeah, the name's locked in.
Dude, when I see Kobe voice chat, I just grab my spoon.
And Phil, I have six tattoos.
Nice. And Z's got his beat, I think, in all of that department.
Four names.
Yeah,
and I have a Keith Haring and then a smiley face on my thigh.
Smiley face on my thigh.
Classic. Why do you have the smiley face on the thigh? And where on the thigh?
The middle of my thigh. So
okay.
It's a bread.
Is it naked? Just like two dots in a... No. Naked. He's going to do it anyway. Get your spoons out, everybody.
Get your spoons out. I thought I'd be able to lift up my pant. Oh, there it is.
Dude, can we start selling a shirt that just has a spoon on it?
Yes.
At all.
Nice. I saw it, yeah.
You're not even going to be able to
see it. The YouTube audience just got a show. But if you're listening on Spotify, tune into YouTube. You just got a show and a spoon. A spoon and a show.
Walmart's it for me. So can you do it again?
Sure.
Please don't. Sure. Can you put the spoon on your nose? Yeah, there it is.
I'm going to do it right now.
Love it. All right, NZ, I'll go next to make sure that you and Shaggy will go after me. Okay. Two truths and a lie. Here we go. I bartended for Vin Diesel, and he has the highest voice known to mankind. I went to a trial camp for Arsenal Football Club when I was 9 years old, and I won the MVP of that camp. And I have been to 5 continents.
The second one.
First one. Vin Diesel.
Yeah, the continents. It's going to be like continents.
Why? That's
I'll say him again.
South America, Asia, Europe.
Am I got another one in you? 6 continents, right?
I mean, Australia. I don't know.
Seven. Way Australia and Antarctica.
Okay.
Oh, in America, that's terrible education. Oh, okay.
So what are you guys going with?
Continents.
Arsenal.
I'm going with the first one.
Arsenal. Vin Diesel. Okay.
Vin Diesel.
I'm pretty sure you told me that. I'm about the high voice.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm going with the soccer one. You're tall.
Sports.
Yeah, but some tall kids like take a long time to figure out what the fuck's going on with their limbs. 9-year-old SPJ just fucking bambying it out there.
He was freaking Peter Crouch out there, probably.
Yeah, all right, SPJ, what is it?
So the lie is that I have been to 5 continents.
How many?
I did, 2 actually. I've only been to 2.
What,
But I've been, I mean, I've been all over Europe and all over North America.
Why would you lie to us? Why would you lie to us?
I'm a lying guy, man.
I can't trust you anymore.
I know. I did, bartending for Vin Diesel was one of my, the best things that at the time was so fucking funny because, dude, guys, this motherfucker had the highest voice I've, you know how Vin Diesel in the movies was like, I'm Triple X, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I walked up to him. I was working an event in London for Triple X, the second one. And my responsibility for this event was to take care of Vin Diesel. So I was like kind of nervous, you know. I was like, fuck, I have to take care of Vin Diesel. And I walked up to him, he's sitting down, head's glistening. And I was like, hello, Mr. Diesel. You know, how are you? Can I get you anything? And he looks at me and he goes, yeah, I'd like a vodka Red Bull, please. And I was like,
That wasn't Vin Diesel.
Imagine.
That was a big Vin Diesel.
I was this close to the guy, and it was definitely Vin Diesel. He also was kind of fat. It was Finn, yeah, fake Diesel. And I was like, what did you say that you wanted? Yeah, I'd like a vodka Red Bull. And I was like, okay, thanks.
You know he's the voice
I'll be back.
Of Iron Giant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Superman.
Mm-hmm. It was wild, dude. I will never forget standing in front of him. Like, that was my face. Yeah. So there you go. But I have not been to Five Continents. So. Shaggy. All right. Shaggy.
All right. You guys ready?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
I have never broken a bone. Mm-hmm. I once ran a sub 430 mile, and I held a cross country record at two different high schools.
Sub 430 mile.
I'm going to go with the first one.
I know the last one's true.
Yeah, I agree to that. What was the first one? I never broke a bone. I still feel like it's the second one.
If you try to tell us that you broke your nose, I'm driving down to Kansas City to beat the shit out of you because that's not a bone.
I think number two.
Yeah,
I'm going to go two.
Sook?
The first one.
Yes.
I think he just wants us to know that he can run away from us and we can't catch him.
That he's running a sub. Do you know how hard it is to run a 430 mile, man? That's like really fucking hard.
I don't know what a mile
is. He was like 16. And like,
I don't know what a mile is.
That's two coming clicks.
1.6 kilometers. 1.6
400 meters. 400 meters almost times four.
1600.
I'll still go with the first one.
I'll still go with the first one.
What if he did it once?
It was the sub 430 mile. I did not do that. I've never broken a bone, though. Never broken a bone in my body. I only got down to like a 442 mile. That was the quickest I've ever gotten. But yeah, then I had the freshman 5K record at one high school and the school 5K record at my other one.
Nice.
Touché.
And then I graduated from a different one.
You went to three high schools?
I was a troubled kid. Let's put it that way.
Really?
Imagine the cross country star being the troubled one.
You were a troubled youth.
Running away from his crimes constantly.
Absolutely.
No crimes.
Did you see Nate spray painted the principal's car again, and then he just
Who?
Ran away?
Who?
Oh, sorry, Stone.
Who?
Who?
Who? All right, SBJ, you've had an hour and a half to think about this.
It's not me.
You mean
NZ?
NZ, sorry.
Oh, man. Who brought this
guy? Oh,
who brought that guy?
We're calling him.
So, the first one is I had my appendix taken out when I was 17 years old. I was once thrown out of an Islanders playoff game, and I was arrested. And I have a stencil of a dinosaur tattoo on my thigh.
That's a lie.
Nah, you didn't get thrown out and arrested of an Islander game.
You got thrown out, but you didn't get arrested.
Yeah, that's
we found out in episode one that he got fucking almost arrested at the Giants parade when they won the Super Bowl.
Yeah. Another troubled
I'm gonna go and troubled youth. What is up with the troubled youths around here? I'm going with that too, the Islanders game.
Yeah. Sook is correct. I was thrown out, but I was not arrested.
Yeah.
Dude, Daddy NZ popped the cop down. He's like, oh, I gotta go tuck in my kids. I can't be in the drunk tank. Miss me with this shit.
I was like, I was young, but just for the record, there's the dinosaur.
There it is.
A lot of
showing off
in tonight.
You zoom in and you zoom in and then move it.
I can't even figure out which way is left and right, bro. Like, let alone zoom in.
Where's the spoon?
We're showing off thigh tats in this hoe. Is that what we're doing?
Oh wow.
Can you move over a little bit and center yourself?
Yeah, you wish.
I have. You know what's funny? I have a thigh tattoo as well. Do we all have thigh tattoos?
I have two.
Not so. Sook doesn't have any.
I have scars. I'll show you my scar on my knee.
He's got the natural tat. Okay.
I have stretch marks. Yeah, does that count?
Oh my god.
Like, I knew when I did this, I was like, you can't say that you used to be fat. Like, that's the easiest out, like, truth of them all.
We all know that, too.
That's day one things that I tell everybody.
Nice tits, bro.
The crotch has some big ones. It's weird. Like, the thigh area, there's one that I shit you not, it's like that thick.
Dude,
right in the old like crevice.
How did you, real, before we talk about what's happening this week, because this is very important. How did you lose the weight? Like, what was your method for, you know, dropping? How much weight did you lose?
So, I started June 20th, 2015.
Okay.
I started eating all three meals, and that was like I lost 30 pounds and. Quick, fast, and like I was down 30 pounds by like August, and then I started working out and still doing that, and then a year later I was down 50 pounds. I think I lost a total of like 75.
Congrats.
Good for you. Okay. Yeah. Nice, man. And now he's a handsome motherfucker that likes spoons. There you go. See?
But now it's like my biggest fear is getting fat again. So like I don't have a great relationship with food. So like that's like my, everyone's got something. That's my thing.
That's why you always
like my weight is like, it's not the best.
Is that your biggest fear?
Oh yeah, by far. Like really? I dwell. Yeah, it's not fun. It's a me thing, and I'm working on it. You know.
That's okay. Before we dive into this week, do you guys want to get dark with it?
Yeah.
Dark.
I was gonna ask.
Is this betting news after dark?
This is basically betting news after dark. This is the vibe check, though. If you guys are enjoying, thanks for tuning in. Appreciate you guys being here. Shaggy, what's your biggest fear?
Oh, he's going to me first. Dude, I'll be honest, man.
Mine is making my heart race.
Now, NZ just jumped.
Thinking about it? Dude, I really like don't fear much. And I don't want to say that it's like a cop-out, but like, to take it to a very dark place, when I was a troubled youth, I was extremely depressed, you know, suffered major depression, anxiety, all that stuff. And I have like since come out on the other side and I almost feel untouchable.
What about like losing somebody?
I mean, yeah, that's like a fear, obviously, but I feel like that's, you know, kind of too easy of an answer per se. I don't know. Losing family members, obviously probably like the biggest fear, but like, I mean, I don't know. Not much else. Like, I don't,
this guy's like a snake and a spider combined. Oh, I'll eat it.
I'll feed the spider to the snake and then kill that motherfucker.
Oh God.
You can also ask any of my friends. I do not fear peer pressure at all. That is
like, oh, yeah, that's the easiest. Like, they made it sound like it was so impossible as a kid to say no, and I was just, I've been saying no ever since they told me I wouldn't be able to say no.
The easiest thing ever.
Come on, Kobe, smoke this marijuana. Nope, I went to school. They told me I should say no to this.
Dare. Dare.
And then when I, did try it, I was like, this is because I want to do it.
A rebel. You're just a rebel. Shaggy kind of copped out and didn't give an answer, but he did. Yeah, we did find out that it's okay. It's all good. Sook, biggest fear?
Yeah, I'll go dark. Kind of like what Kobe was. You're gonna feel bad about how dark I'm gonna get, Kobe. In between the time that I tore my knee and tore my Achilles, my partner actually got a brain tumor. And it was considered very large, and that's all we knew. And she basically couldn't, like, exist. She was just puking all the time, had no cognition, no balance at all. And we didn't know what was going to happen. And then luckily we found out it was a special kind of tumor called an acoustic schwannoma. And it was on her hearing nerve, on her ear, and that's why she couldn't have balance or anything. So that was a breath of fresh air. She got the surgery done. And then she had further complications because of her medication. And then she ended up having, after I healed from my Achilles being torn, she got AVN necrosis in her hips. And she had to have both her hips replaced. So it was like 4 or 5 years of absolute medical hell. So that's, for me, my biggest fear is ever losing her, because I was in a position where I thought that was going to happen. So to ever be back in that spot, I think that is 100% will always be my biggest fear.
That's just like also kind of an incredible journey between you two as well.
Yeah.
Like you guys were both sharing a moment of, hers was a little more intense than yours, but still two intense like journeys that you both had to endure at like a crucial time of your life, like your teenage years.
Yeah. Mm. Well, our 20s. But the one good thing was that, like with me, I got my knee experimentally redone, and my knee is fucking awesome. I play ball, I work out, it's fine, no problems, doesn't hurt. And with her, she had her hip replacement done experimentally as well. So she actually had like a really cool surgery where she was in and out of the hospital after one night, where usually you're in the hospital for 7 days, and she actually works out even more than I do, and she's in great shape, goes to the gym 6-7 times a week. So we're actually super blessed.
Shout out, Kanika.
Nothing like the early battles to get out of the way for like the rest of your life, you know? Like, everyone's got a battle. You know what I mean?
Now I see people.
That's how I view life. Like, everyone's got a battle at a certain point. Mm-hmm. Some come later.
Dude, now I see people and they're like, oh, yeah, my in-laws are always calling or some little bullshit. And I'm like, dude, come on. Just call them back. Don't call them back. Don't complain. Move on with life.
Hey, man, perspective is everything. It's all about perspective.
Perspective is a huge thing.
Mm-hmm. Massive. Well, shout out Kanika. And yeah, that's a good way to make sure that you guys are bonded.
The first time when I was 16, so we were pretty much bonded there.
You what? What did you say?
Nothing. I'm not repeating that.
What did he say? What did he say?
He said what you thought he said.
I don't know what he said.
You're going to have to listen to the podcast tomorrow.
Yeah, you're going to have to listen to the recording.
Is that what he said?
It's approximately at the 53-minute mark. So
you're telling me she said, and then you were like, oh, that's her? Is that what I got?
No.
Oh, okay.
So not exactly that.
I don't care.
There was a spoon involved, though. All right, Inzi. Side.
I mean,
bombastic side eye.
Look at this.
Bombastic side eye.
Fucking weirdo.
Bombastic side eye.
I'm not gonna go. Inzi, like, which dark? I won't go dark like that. But I mean, obviously, anything God forbid happens to my wife and kids. But one of my biggest fears is my house catching on fire. That is something that I fear like all the time, as random as that sounds. But that when once you said when you were like, oh, all right, everybody, what's your big? That was like the first thing that came.
First thing that pops into your head.
First thing. God forbid, my dogs, my home, just it just. But I guess you know that's life. That's how you leave your home every day. That's what you know. Knock on wood. You know.
Sure.
Have you seen Manchester by the Sea?
No, and something tells me I don't want to.
Do not fucking watch that movie. Anybody listening that's seen Manchester by the Sea, do not fucking let NZ watch that movie.
All right. Oh, God. Never watching that.
Yeah.
That movie made me want to.
Right now, Manchester by the Sea.
Won a lot of awards, but God, that movie is.
Oh, yeah. This absolutely looks like a movie I'm not watching. Yeah.
Oh man, fires! All I smell is fires from that movie.
Yeah. Hey, Matthew Broderick.
Yeah. He killed people. That'd be Matthew Broderick.
And didn't go to jail.
Matthew Broderick did.
Yeah, in London or England somewhere, he got into a car accident drunk and killed a woman and a daughter and didn't go to jail.
Simba.
Sheesh.
Yeah, Simba.
Jeez.
Look it up. Look it up.
So Ferris, right. Ferris Bueller.
Yeah, Ferris Bueller. Yeah.
You're so DUI. Oh
my God.
Killed two people.
Wow. It's like fucking Henry Ruggs. Or is it Henry Ruggs? Right?
Henry Ruggs.
The Raiders wide receiver?
Yeah.
Yeah. Henry Ruggs. I didn't expect us to do this on the pod, but you know. Hey man, everybody deals with demons, right? Everybody has things that you're scared of. Everybody has things that deals. Everybody obviously has different levels of demons that they deal with on a daily basis. If you have deep demons, hope that you're getting the help that you need to deal with them every day. My biggest fear is failure of any type. And I know that that's a shit thing because you're always going to fail. But I hate the pressure that I feel from possibly failing, the things about what happens when you do fail. But I think just being able to not always do exactly what I want to do all the time is something that the demon that I battle consistently. But I figured out ways to make sure that I don't have to deal with it every single day and to give myself pats on the back for the good things that I've been able to accomplish, even if it's not, even if, you know, the failure, because you're always going to fucking fail, right? Yeah. So,
shape or form.
I think
as long as you know it's good failure, like there's good and bad.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can learn from
that. Well, and you should
well, and everybody seek failure equals success as well, or not seeking it in a way that's healthy. Like you're not going to succeed unless you fail.
Well, that's the thing too, is like I picked a career before I did this of performing or acting, and like 95% of acting is fucking failing, like all the time. You go to auditions and you get told no, and you go to these things and you get told you suck, and you go to this and you go to that, and it's like failure, 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 failure. So how you cope with failure is like the way that you persevere through your life, I think. But I'm still scared to, I don't know. It's just that constant feeling of like you're never going to do good enough, you know? So kind of that pressure that weighs down on you. But
what's that Winston Churchill quote? Success is never final and failure is never fatal.
Mm-hmm.
And that's also, I think we're super depressing because I think Kaneko was listening from the other room and she just fucking passed me a beer. So she's trying to fix the vibes here.
Kind of change it up. Well, hey man, you know, like obviously we like to vibe out and we have a great time doing all this. Wife. Also, shout out Kaneko. We're glad you're alive and the tumor did not take you.
Kaneko.
Hey man, you know, we obviously like talk you
before you went to that story too. Jesus Christ. As soon as I said that, I'm like, you're going to regret saying that.
Well, if you're listening to this, because, you know, we talk about vibes all the time on the shows that we do. We obviously like to be positive with all of you guys and each other, obviously, all the time. But if you're listening to this and you're dealing with something tough, go talk about it. Talk to a friend, family member, get some help, figure out a way to, you know, get those demons out there. Because sometimes they're never going to go away, and that's okay. But figuring out ways to talk with your buddies about it, talk with your family, talk with your friends, a coping mechanism, whatever it is, that's a good coping mechanism.
Right,
if you're dealing with something, a safe coping mechanism. whatever it is, you know, we're all dealing with shit. So even though this is a positive space, and we hope that this has been positive for you and you're enjoying fucking listening to the Vibe Check this week. Let's talk about next week. If you guys are listening to us in the middle of the week, some of these things might have already happened. But what things, gents, are we looking forward to moving into this week? Mr. Shaggy Betts, Mr. Snacky Snack, what are you looking forward to going into this week?
Family Guy is back on Wednesday. I'm so excited. We haven't had a new episode in a while. Huge Family Guy fan. New episode on Wednesday.
Not since Christmas, right?
It's been a whole like winter break, basically. So yeah, this is the new spring premiere, per se. So
it seems today that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV. Where are those good old fashioned values?
Come on, Shaggy, it's your show.
Is it a Family Guy?
Come on, Ezzy.
I don't watch that shit.
There we go. And Z, what are you looking forward to this week, brother? He watches American Dad, probably, because he is an American Dad.
He watches real cartoons because he has kids.
Coco Melon.
I don't know. I was going to say, I don't know if, like, I watch Disney. That's what I watch. I watch Disney. And by the way, I've watched Up about 10,000 times. Okay, just so you guys know.
Yeah. Did you cry in the first minute and a half?
No, because you guys all prepped me for it. So I was like, oh, this is the sad part.
I was numb to it already.
But I feel like there was a part at the end. There's a part at the end that made me kind of sad. Oh, when he went and stood up for the kid at the little ending thing when the kid got his little badge or whatever.
And you realize like his dad is dead.
Well, right. Oh, I don't know. I thought he had
said well, way to ruin dead. The movie.
Yeah, wait, what?
Hope people have seen this old movie. But anyways. It's a child's movie. I don't know, man.
Hey, it's a movie for all people.
I'm just hopeful. I'm hopeful for peace this week again. I'm looking for my third week in a row of peace, so I'll take that. But otherwise, everything's copacetic around here. Nothing crazy going on. We're going to the circus next Saturday, actually. Who am I kidding? I'm going to the circus.
Ooh.
I'm going like an actual circus?
I'm going to
like, UBS. Really? Is it the what is the famous what is the what's the Harmon and Brothers? No,
Barnum and Bailey.
Barnum and Bailey, is that what it is?
Yeah, I believe so.
Nice.
Yeah. Sick. So we say my in-laws are taking us and my kids and then the rest of my nephews and nieces. So nice. Should be cool. We'll see. Actually, my pops is going to tag along, so we'll see. We'll see how that goes. Should be cool.
Nice.
I haven't been to the circus since I was a little kid, so God only knows what it's like now. I was told there's no live animals, and I personally think that's bullshit. I don't know how you fill the void of live animals at a circus, but I'm going to find out.
Holographics. You're going to learn on Saturday. All right. I'll go next. Mine's on Sunday, and it's nice and easy. Boys, we've made it past the darkest days of winter. The clocks are moving forward on Sunday, March the 10th. We are back out of daylight savings time, which should be fucking obliterated. Send it to the fucking sun. So excited for the clocks to change back. Spring is almost here. It's very, very stoked. So Sunday. Next time we're recording this podcast, we will be in the light of the evening. It will be getting closer and closer to where it's going to be fucking, you know, dark at 8 instead of dark at 5.
Hell yeah.
And then it's that'll light. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. That's the best.
Yeah.
Yeah. Early going to walk? Hell yeah.
It is rough waking up when it's pitch black out.
Oh, my God. Dude. It's like dude. Last year, I started taking morning walks because I'm like, I should just get up and do something before I go to work. So I'd get up at like 5:50 and then go on an hour walk and then go back home and eat and then leave immediately. And I was like, all right, let's see how long I can do this. Did it all summer. And then as soon as it started getting, it was dark until 7. I'm like, I'm not going outside. It's not really cold.
Did you say you went on a walk for an hour?
Yeah. I live right next to the lake.
Okay. Nice.
Okay.
You just take the lake trail, I guess you call it.
The lake route. Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, I go for hour walks, Colby.
Yeah. Dude, walks are the best. That's where I get my ideas.
Walks are the best.
I'll continue going since I'm still talking. but a little side note, do you guys cry when you watch movies?
Yeah.
I mean, depends on the movie.
Yeah, same. Yes.
Do like, when I saw War Dogs, I didn't cry.
Yeah, War Dogs.
Like, growing up, I'd be like, why are people crying? Like, how could a movie make you cry? And then I, like, as soon as I got, like, into college or, like, out of the house, I, like, cannot stop crying over sad movies. And I'm like, man, what the hell is going on? I'll be watching a movie with my girlfriend, and I'll be like, just wait for this part. This is the cutest fucking thing you'll ever fucking see. And I'm, like, over here crying, and I watched the movie the night before, but I was like, yo, you gotta watch this with me. And we'll watch it, and I'm over there on the couch, just like, is that the fucking cutest thing you've ever fucking seen? And she's like,
Don't watch Disney movies because they kill all the grandmas. All the grandmas.
Oh, no. The last
or the parents.
They don't make it. I don't get it.
What movie is that? It's the last movie that made me like really cry. It was that Bill Murray movie where he's the neighbor and he like takes care of that kid. St. Vincent. It's the end where he like goes on the stage. I'm just like, you know, the you've ever fucking seen.
Wait, have you ever seen Wonder?
The kid with the ears like flat. Yes, that one was a tearjerker too.
That's what I was gonna say. If you haven't, you'll cry at the end of that one.
Anything with a father son like tear jerking moment, I'm bawling my eyes out. Anything like that.
Was this going somewhere with what you're looking forward to this week, or was this just a random Colby fact?
I just want to see if you guys cried.
Oh, okay. All right. Would you like to give us?
Yeah. The thing I'm looking forward to is Tuesday. I'm going to the DePaul game, and I get to see Rick Pitino, and I'm 1,000% wearing a suit, like a sports jacket.
Where are you and your friends eating?
Oh, and then before my coworkers and I, we're going to the Italian restaurant across the street from the Winchester Arena to pay homage to Rick Pitino, since he had that tryst in that bathroom.
Love it.
He had what?
He had a tryst.
What is a
sexual
tryst?
A sexual encounter in the bathroom.
Oh, I've never heard it called a tryst.
I saw it in an article, and I was like, I'm adding that to my vocabulary.
It's called a glory hole.
What?
I thought it was a different thing, dude.
Different thing. Hold on. Let me look up the definition of tryst for us.
I thought you were going to look up glory hole, and I was like, dude, don't Google that. Oh, God.
Yeah, let me share my screen real quick.
Yeah, it says, all right, we'll look up Blue Waffle after this. It says a private rendezvous with lovers. Keep a private romantic rendezvous as a verb.
Private rendezvous.
Tryst.
Thank you for adding that to my vocabulary. Yeah,
it's a great word.
All right, boys. This week on all of our different shows on betting news on streams every week, everyone has to try to use the word tryst every show.
Shaggy and I have a tryst every time we go on stream.
Yeah. There you go. See? Yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal.
See how
we accomplish it. Oh man. So if your name is Tristan, do you just do a lot of trysts? Nah, that's a conversation for a different day. So, what are you looking forward to this week?
We should ask Tristan. We happen to know one.
We should ask said Tristan if he likes to tryst. All right, Sook. Are you looking forward to trysting with Kanika this week, or what's up?
Me during a tryst.
Oh,
girl!
Yikes!
Oh, girl. Man.
If you're just listening to this, Colby just showed us his curled toes.
His curled toes.
Legit curled toes.
The intensity at its max.
Take the fucking sock off. Be a man.
Be a man. Be a man.
All right. You two get your own studio. All right. Both of you. There are five of
Shaggy.
Us in here. All right. I don't want to hear or see any of that.
Shaggy, do you not like feet?
No, I don't give a fuck.
Oh, okay.
I just want these two to get a room, bro.
Fair enough.
You're just jealous he's taking your boyfriend from you.
Yeah, fuck off,
all right?
Huh?
Hey, there it is. There are the toesies.
What the hell is happening?
Off the rails.
I'm not taking my sock off because my feet are nasty. I'm scared of my own feet, to be honest with you.
Oh, man.
Oh, there they are. You guys got it. Ooh. All right, Sook. What's gonna make your toes curl this week?
I mean, right after we get off doing this, I'm gonna go watch Curb Your Enthusiasm.
We just got off doing this. Let's go. Love that.
Yeah, I'm super excited for Curb final season. Richard Lewis just died. His best friend.
That's right.
Super sad. I'm super excited for the rest of the season. So Curb Your Enthusiasm tonight. That's what I'm excited for. Rest of the week is downhill until I see Kobe's toes again.
Oh, baby.
I'll have to send you a surprise tomorrow morning.
I know. Maybe we'll have to watch Stash Bros for a little tryst.
tell Kanika to roll over so she doesn't see the text. Roll over, babe. I got a snap.
Oh, my God. NZ, in this. What are you looking forward to this week? Oh, you already went. Who hasn't gone? Has everyone gone?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
You went. Right?
Did you go?
Yeah, it's everybody.
Did you yourself?
Oh, great. No, I went. Yeah, okay. I went. Yeah, the clock's going forward. All right, let's get out of here.
Enjoyed this tryst that we call this podcast.
For real.
Who had a trystastic time with us today?
Spicy.
You know, tryst sounds like, it almost sounds like tricks. So, like, let's make a tryst cereal, like a romantic.
Oh my God.
I'm going to stop talking.
Doing tryst.
this pod went from fun to depressing to us cry laughing. Yes. I think this was great.
I think that's enough. Coaster of emotions.
Yeah.
Indeed. We hope that you guys have enjoyed episode 3 of The Vibe Check. As always, this was every single week. We'll see you guys next week. Be sure to tune in at everything we got going on at Betting News this week. You can see all of us trying to put tryst into every single one of our streams this week. Wherever you're listening to this, we hope you're having a fucking fantastic week. Hope you guys are having a great day. Jen, say everybody say goodbye to these beautiful people that tuned in with us today. Appreciate you guys being here.
Beautiful people.
Have a great week, everybody. Take it easy. Peace.
It wasn't me that...
Yeah. Yeah. Whoa. That's a vibe. She wanna vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah.